Today we have four strategies to grow your Instagram following here on The Journey.
All right, so you're on Instagram. You probably got a great cadence going already with how often you're posting, but you're definitely thinking, how do I get more followers, right? I know I was asked that actually just recently when I was doing a seminar in Orlando. Mm-hmm. And it's a good thing to think about because the more followers, the more likes.
Right.
The more likes, spread more word of mouth.
Yeah, the more conversions to your website, the more you grow, all these fun things, right?
Yeah, but as I always get asked, well, what are best practices to get more followers on Instagram? So we're gonna break it down into four ways to gain more followers, starting with, don't skip over that bio. Make an awesome bio about your business. I know, I have a favorite one. There was this pub in LA when I lived there, and they did this really bold move. They decided to go 100% vegan.
Interesting for a pub.
Yeah. And in their bio, it says, oh, kale, yeah, we're plant-based. So they get right to
love
it.
Love a good pun.
Oh, kale, yeah, we should get shirts.
That's all you. No.
Just me?
Just you.
Me. All right. Anyway, so like it's their announcement that, hey, we're plant-based now. It's also funny, which is their voice, their sense of humor. And then from there, they like have added links, for example, if they want to direct you to their website or anything that they're promoting that month. So when it comes to your bio, that was just one example. Okay, yeah, we're plant-based. But I also recommend if you've been in business for a long time, whenever you open up, add that. That's what's always a big one for me, especially when I'm checking out like an auto repair shop. I want to know they're not just like the new shop in town. It makes me feel like I can trust them more if they've been around a while. So I'd also incorporate anything that really demonstrates your personality or your vibe. So if you're a restaurant and you're known for fine dining, like let people know that so you get the right audience versus if you're super like divey, hipster, vegan, crunchy place.
Exactly, right?
I'll be there.
Yep, she'll be there. I might try it. But with your bio, you really want to be strategic about what you put out there. Basically put how you actually help your followers and what they're going to get out of it. The more that you describe like, cool, what's in it for them, they're gonna read that and go, oh cool, that's me. Like I wanna talk about or see vegan pubs or I wanna have help with real estate or I wanna have help with whatever. Put helping you do blah, whatever that is, add that in there. And what a cool little trick is, so in Instagram bio, you can't really do those line breaks. Mm-hmm. It'll make it just one giant paragraph, but instead, open up notes like on your phone, add your bios there, add your line breaks, your emojis, whatever you want to do, then copy pasta that over. And then it's like all nice and organized. It's little sentences versus one giant paragraph.
Yeah, absolutely. And one thing I would also include, you mentioned real estate and then I started thinking about home services and I started thinking about where your service area might be or areas. So if you only service certain cities, you know, spell that out for your customers as well. So at a glance, I know, hey, it's worth picking up the phone and calling you to do business with you as a potential customer or not.
All right, now with including the bio is the link that Instagram gives us. It's the only place where we can link to another source. What are some things that we should basically link to there?
Yeah, so there's a lot of options. I know I actually did this recently for The Journey. I added the YouTube link for all of our videos.
Yeah, I saw that. You basically posted about it and say, hey, check out the link in the bio.
Yeah.
And then went right to the video.
Did you click on it?
I might have, seven times.
So if you want to direct people to a YouTube channel that you're doing or other social media platforms that you're on, or maybe you're offering a really exciting discount or a special giveaway, and then you direct them to there. And you could do this in your Instagram stories. Hey, link in bio or on your Instagram posts. Oh, check out the link in our bio. So that's a great, I see that a lot, especially for giveaways or 10% off a really cool shirt.
Yeah, I dig it. And then I think last thing with the bio is the basically the display name. What a lot of businesses will do, they'll just put their business name there. But if it's not super apparent about what your business is, maybe that won't resonate with your audience. But you can add your business name and then that line and then basically put the services that you offer, whether it's real estate investing or vegan pubs or whatever that looks like. So when someone's going through searching the feed, they can see your business name and then cool, that industry might entice them to want to jump in and explore your page a bit more.
All right, so that takes us to number two, infuse your Instagram with personality.
What does that actually mean, other than your award-winning personality?
Yes. So that means think about what content you're doing, what you're putting out there. Don't try too hard. it's going to come off that you're trying too hard. Be authentic, be real, and plan ahead. Because that's one thing I noticed too, is that when content is just being rushed, personality is left out completely. So just take the time, think, what is really me? What is my voice? What is my business about? Do I have a good sense of humor?
Yeah, and for the most part, people follow your Instagram page, not only just for the services you offer, but they follow it for you, right? So the more that you share you and just share your day-to-day, your struggles, your wins, your opportunities, and just going on their post about you, the more that you'll really relate to them and connect with that audience, the more willing that they're gonna be to just follow you and your presence.
Yeah, so. As soon as you come off just sounding like a business or predictable or a robot, you're going to get less engagement. And why would I follow you? I'll probably unfollow you if you become too salesy or sound too much like a business. I know that can seem confusing, right? Because you're like, I am a business.
Right. I want to sell my services.
I want to make money. Like, I'm on there to get more business. So yes, I hear you, but consumers, especially millennials, we want to see a personality. So authenticity for the win. And speaking of millennials, I read an interesting stat the other day. It said millennials prefer user-generated content. So be sure to incorporate that on your Instagram. It's like the mecca for user-generated content, which if you don't know what that is, it's essentially content that other people have created for you, about you, like your customers taking pictures of their pizza and then mentioning you. You can repurpose that into your own post. And there was also another stat that said 85% of people, when they see user-generated content, they actually, visual user-generated content, they actually trust it more than businesses, what they're saying about themselves, or brands, or colleagues, or your family. So strangers are pretty powerful.
Yeah. And there's many ways to really create that user-generated content. We've got a video for you to check out up there. But what quick things you can do, run a contest, create just a personalized hashtag with your business and tell everyone to hashtag it. And then you can go search those hashtags and then all that user-generated content is there. Reach out to them, say, hey, do you mind if I post this? Get their permission just in case. And then add that content to your own feed, create that user-generated content, get people to really like you and buy into your business, and you win and you grow your following.
Another awesome way to infuse personality in your Instagram, it's actually really quite simple. Ask questions.
Like what?
So I saw there, that was good. It's working.
It's working.
So I saw this hotel and they did a post on Instagram and it said, I feel most at home when I have blank. So the hotel asking that question was just a really cool way to not only get their audience engaged, because people love to talk about themselves.
Right.
But they also then shared what makes them feel most at home. It was like curled up with a book, cozy with some hot tea.
Yeah, and another added benefit with that is now they're getting basically survey data of their audience, what makes them feel at home. They collect the kind of the best examples, make sure they include that in their hotel too.
I didn't even think that's so true.
Yeah.
Because what if someone's like really enjoys cucumber water?
Yep.
Put that in your lobby.
Makes them feel at home.
So another really simple and effective way to infuse personality on your Instagram, besides asking questions and user-generated content, showcase your team. I mean, what a great way to like be authentic and show who's behind the scenes, you know? Do some BTS, how is that recipe coming together? Who's underneath the hood of the car when I get my oil changed? Like, who makes this business? Plus, when you see a familiar face at some of your favorite local businesses as a customer, sometimes that's all I need is just like a little incentive to go back and visit you.
Yeah, absolutely. And I know we do this a lot at GoDaddy. Our guides are the face of our brand, and you can basically do it the same with your employees. Like, they're the face of your brand. They're representing your business every day. So show them off, tell their story, let the people connect with them, and it should help them just resonate with your audience and build that loyalty.
All right, so the third way that we want to talk about actually getting more followers on Instagram, we've kind of touched on it, but hashtags. Other popular hashtags, like just industry-wise, think about it. And you can Google this, you know, what industry you're in. Let's say you're in retail. Popular hashtags to use if you're in retail. You Google it right now. And one that I love to see, especially for some inspo, some fashion inspo, hashtag OOTD. You know what that stands for?
Outfit of the day.
That's right, Neely pays attention to what he
wears. I'm hip with the lingo.
He's hip. and hip with the clothes. So retail, you'll see that a lot, OOTD. And a lot of people love to use it to just get, like I said, inspiration for their fashion. And it's gonna help you to get in front of new customers, more followers, which is what this video is all about. But don't stop there. Don't stop with just industry specific hashtags or branded. You can also do neighborhood or local hashtags.
Okay. Yeah. So like for in Seattle, like hashtag Seattle Coffee, for example, to
yes.
really bring around Seattle Coffee.
Yeah, that would be a great spot, you know, branch out outside of Starbucks, find a local business to go to where we could get a cup of coffee before we come in and shoot the journey.
And with these hashtags too, it's not necessarily just for you to post about, really join in on the conversation of other people basically talking about these hashtags. What I'd recommend, spend like 10, 15 minutes a night, search a couple of hashtags and just start adding conversation to other people's posts and adding value. Don't just put generic comments because nobody's gonna care about that. People are just gonna think you're spam. But if you actually go in and add value, continue on the conversation, maybe ask questions, it's really gonna help you connect with a larger audience and show that you're an actual person, not just a faceless business. All right, Emma, did you know that 70% of people on Instagram watch Instagram stories on a daily basis?
No, but I'm not surprised. I definitely spend way more time on Instagram stories than just like scrolling through my Insta newsfeed.
I feel the same way.
I know.
Just going through the stories. It's authentic and it shows personality.
Which tees up our fourth way to get more followers. Incorporate fan content, like user generated,
okay,
into your Instagram stories.
So like, instead of like reposting it, basically posting onto your story?
Yeah, so for example, I recently got a new surfboard. It's my baby. I love it. Can't wait to go home and surf. I recently got this new surfboard and I was curious about the brand, and the brand is Modern Surfboards. And I checked out their Instagram, and what really sold me was their Instagram stories. And they are doing an awesome job of repurposing their fans' content. And so this is a really cool way to see people like me, potential customer. Well, for them, it was already a customer. And they're out there like getting pitted and showing off their boards. So I got inspo for like what board I wanted to get. I also just like increased my hype to go catch some waves. But it was really cool to see their fans and where they're surfing and what boards they're intrigued by. And it got me really excited. And the good news is, like we mentioned earlier, Instagram is the mecca of fan content. But it is your responsibility to be paying attention to when people are mentioning you, like you were talking about earlier.
You'll get a notification, and you can go one step further. Not only reposting their post, you can repost their stories. Now, the only way to do this is if they mention you in their story. So encourage your fans, your followers, to mention you in their story when they talk about you. That way you can repost it on your own channel. Because if they don't do it, you won't be able to do it.
And it makes it really easy too. Like Neely is great about this when we're doing the journey shoot, and he'll mention me and then it just pops up in my inbox on Instagram, and I'm like, oh, Neely mentioned me.
Get a little add this to your story.
What did he capture?
What did I do?
First, let me check it. Oh, this is cool. And then I can just click add this to my story.
Super quick. Add a little GIF, add some conversation, say, hey, thanks for the shout out or whatever you want to do. Make it personal. Don't just click the mention in my story. Add your little 2 cents to it. It'll really basically like resonate with that person. Now they think they're a little Insta famous too.
All right, that's a wrap. You just learned 4 ways to gain more Instagram followers. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe.
Ring that bell if you want to get these episodes first. This is The Journey. See you next time.